Jai Shri Ram, welcome to Astrology with Abhilasha. Today I am taking a very frequently asked upon question, that is how to decode the pending karma of a chart and how to make prediction basis on this. I will also take an example chart to tell you how I have predicted a pending karma in the birth chart and how I also decoded what is the current scenario going on with a person. But before doing that, we should understand the whole complete logic of this term. Karma and pending karma. So what I've generally seen nowadays is that pending karma is only getting attached to the houses like 6th house, 8th house, and people telling you what is the technique to decode it from the sign of Scorpio or Virgo only. But that is not the complete picture, in my opinion. What I have seen while experimenting through charts, taking up charts, giving predictions, doing it on several platforms, what I've understood is that pending karma is not only about one house lord in the complete scheme of 12 houses. Do you think pending karma or the association of your past life karma has to be with only one house? I haven't seen this working in my practical knowledge. What I understood after going through several charts and giving out predictions and decoding the complete methodology of coming to the conclusion is that, do you think our birth is without any karma behind it? Our existence in itself is the proof that there is a whole lot of karma behind it. So the complete horoscope is all about pending karma. We cannot attach just one single house, one single sign, or a single planet to pending karma. We have to see the chart holistically to decode one event and then giving a miraculous remedy which actually changes the complete scheme of your life. I've seen it happening in front of my eyes. It's just like putting the right key in the lock and just opening new vistas to the native. But again, coming back to the point that I do not feel, rather I am sure after going through several horoscopes that pending karma cannot be attached to one single house or a sign, just like Scorpio or Virgo. It has to be in the view of complete horoscope. The complete natal chart is all about our pending karma. Because that is the source of our birth. So today, the technique which I'm going to tell you is about the germinating of a karma. Our whole existence is karma. So the first house, the ascendant lord, and the placement of ascendant lord is the biggest karma in your horoscope. Your ascendant lord, your ascendant is the reason due to which you have taken birth in this planet, on this planet. These last few videos are the part of my core research, which I'm sharing out with you. I hope you understand the worth of it, apply it, and see how beautifully it works. And how simple does it get to decode the pending karma of a person by this method, by just taking the ascendant and the ascendant lord? Because your ascendant is the rising sign at the time of your birth. Can you deny the fact that it is not the biggest portion of your pending karma? Your ascending sign, your ascendant lord, isn't it the biggest portion of your pending karma? Because that is the portion which is rising in the complete scheme of 12 zodiac signs at the time of your birth. That is the name given to you by God. So how can you deny the importance of your ascendant sign, of your ascendant lord, while decoding the scheme of pending karma, or decoding the reason you're here in this world? How can you deny the importance of this? So the technique which I'm going to tell you is to check the ascendant sign, the ascendant lord, and where it is placed in the chart. And while discussing this technique on the chart, I will keep on telling you small bits and pieces of techniques further which you should use to actually come to the crux of the events which are taking place in the native's life currently. That is how you make a prediction. That is how you give a complete storyboard to the native. Seeing a chart is nothing but making a storyboard of the light of the life of the native, and then correcting the errors which the native is making by the way of free will, by the way of kriyaman karma. We should completely understand how many portions karma is divided into. Whatever we are getting, is it a part of prarabdha karma? Yes, it is. Sanchit karma. Now what we are doing is kriyaman karma, and what we will be doing in future is agami karma. So where is the free will portion? Where a human being is getting the free will portion to do a remedy? That portion is called kriyaman karma. That is very important to understand. We cannot change the prarabdha or sanchit. We can only fiddle with kriyaman. So that is where the remedy should come out from. So let's move forward and check by the way of an horoscope. And I would also like to add that in the coming video, or maybe in this video while discussing this chart, I will also tell you the importance of the most important planets you have to see in a birth chart to decode the complete theme of your birth, complete theme of the birth of the native. How we do that? If I get the time while recording this video, I will do that also. So, right. I'll take up a chart. And do it for you guys. So this is the chart which I got sometime back to read. And here I had to decode what is the current theme which is going to the person's life. So by the method which I'm telling you in the video, let's check out the ascendant and the ascendant lord of the native. He is an Aquarius ascendant. Now, by Aquarius ascendant, we understand that Saturn becomes a very important planet in his chart. And Saturn would be the major planet distributing the events because of his pending karma, his prarabdha and sanchit. So we take, where does Saturn goes in the chart? It goes in the 11th house. Saturn is retrograde. The ascendant lord is retrograde itself. Now, these specific attributes which is attached to a planet, retrogression, debilitation, exaltation, adds up to the amount of actions which gonna take place in the life of the native. These are added strength also. So we should understand this as well, that what are the added strengths to the planet which we are looking at. Now Saturn, which we are taking as the most karmic planet, being the ascendant lord, is going into the 11th house. It is sitting in the sign Sagittarius in 11th house. What does Sagittarius sign depict? Guru, knowledge, father, travels, everything. Now, let's see. This is the one part. Saturn, okay, it's retrograde, heavy karma, right? We got it. Sitting in Sagittarius sign, something to do with the attributes of Sagittarius. Now, also see where does the Lord of Sagittarius is going? It is going in the fourth house. Fourth house depicts your mother, property, land, luxury, vehicle, everything. Your motherland as well. Now, I told this person that Saturn is also Karak of disputes. There is a dispute of your father with you regarding the property matters. You are very anguished on your father because of the way he treated your mother. Because here, what do we see? Why I told mother specifically, the concentration of planet in the fourth house. All positive planet in the fourth house. So the native's heart is in the fourth house. He is with his mother. He is totally inclined towards the property. There is the complete gravity of the chart. Right? And the karmic planet, Saturn, is making a relation by the way of its lord, Jupiter, sitting in the fourth house. Why I said property now? I hope by now you could understand why I said property. One, it is going to the fourth house. Second, Mars is aspecting Saturn. So it is giving the issues of property to the native. Sign Sagittarius with his father. Why he wants to do this? Why he wants to go into a dispute? I told him that you are doing it because to increase your income, to make an investment in your business. Right? But if you do it, the pending karma will be that you might, I had to say might, just not to make the native afraid. But that is the complete scenario which is going to happen. One, he is going to lose all his assets, earning a loss in the property because he ended up in a dispute with his father itself. So this is the pending karma which he has to avoid, taking away of property from his father by the way of dispute. So understand, I told him not to go after the property, wait until his father willingly do it. Otherwise, he will face trouble in his mother's health. And also he will lose the amount he is going to invest in the business. Because Mars is also becoming the 10th lord. Whatever you are going to put in occupation by the way of getting through Mars property, you lose it because there are certain combinations which are showing clear-cut karmic pattern. how I confirmed that certain event has been done in past by your father as well? By the placement of Mars. This is for you guys to understand why there was an event with the father of this native and his grandfather, which showed involvement of property and a similar event in the past. So please understand that it is not, pending karma is not only about the 8th house, the 6th house, 8th lord, 6th lord, no. The ascendant is the main giver of the pending karma. Distribution of anything in your chart is only by the way of ascendant. It is like the powerhouse, the source of power supply to the complete chart. So we should understand this. I hope you got me. I don't want to club too many techniques in this video only, but there is a very beautiful technique to understand the most important planet in your chart, which I'm going to make next. How to decode three most important planet in your birth scope, horoscope, and how to, you know, evaluate the concentration area of your life, where your life will be having the most gravitational pull, which field of your life will have the most power of making you attract. So that is the technique which I wanted to share in this video, but I'll be sharing it in the next video so that you can take it one step at a time and easy and apply this. See, take up a chart, see where the ascendant lord is going, see the condition of ascendant lord, see what the ascendant is. Here the ascendant itself is Aquarius. It is all about his desires, the native's desires. He is driven by his desires to do the karma. Right? So you should understand and apply this technique. I hope you like the video. Jai Shri Ram. See you again. Take care. Bye-bye.